WLJC welcomes you to have church with us during the hour of harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. We know that we're going to hear some good music, and Dottie has phone operators up there if you need to call. Well, that'll be fine. If you have a praise report, if God's answered a prayer for you at last day or so, maybe even today, well, let us hear from you, because it gives Him honor when we tell about how He has answered our prayers. And we all need encouragement from time to time, because that's just the way that we're kind of made up, is that a little encouragement along gives us more faith and more strength to go on and expect and see some more victories. And so tonight from the nursing homes and the hospitals, every place you've joined us, we want to say that we appreciate you letting us come in and visit with you. We'll be here for a couple of hours, and we'll have a lot of music and some good praise reports, we're believing. And I want to read some scripture to you about how that God will answer our prayers even when it's not the ordinary thing to do. And you know, he has the whole picture. Many times we say, well, this should have happened or that should have happened, but we don't know. We see, you know, about just beyond our nose, but God sees with eternity in mind, and so He knows what we need and what we don't need, and we're thankful that that He does do that, because many times I'm sure we ask for things that would do us more harm than it would good. But this scripture I want to share with you, is it really encourages me when I read it, because it talks about God answering prayer. In Isaiah, the 38th chapter, it says, "In those days was Hezekiah sick unto death. And Isaiah the prophet of the son of Amon came unto him and said, Thus saith the Lord, Set thine house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Hezekiah turned his face toward the wall, and he prayed unto the Lord. And he said, Remember now, O Lord, I beseech thee, how I have walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and have done that which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sore. Then came the word of the Lord to Isaiah, saying, Go and say to Hezekiah, Thus saith the Lord, the God of David thy father, I have heard thy prayer, I have seen thy tears. Behold, I will add unto thy days 15 years, and I will deliver thee and this city out of the hand of the king of Assyria, and will defend this city. And on it goes about what God did to answer Hezekiah's prayers. But what I am blessed by when I read this is, now, I don't know how we'd act if we was told, you know, get ready to die. I don't know how we'd act. But here Hezekiah, he went to the Lord and he started talking to him, and he said, I like this part, that he knew that the Lord knew him well enough that he could say, Hey, look, Lord, you remember me. You know how I've lived. You know that I've had a clean heart. And so he is asking for some healing. And God didn't say, No, Hezekiah, you haven't lived that way. He said, He told him, I have heard your prayers. I have heard your prayers, and I have seen thy tears. Behold, I will add unto thee thy days 15 years. So God said, now Hezekiah, I know that you've lived this way, and I'm going to honor this. But you know, it is wonderful to have such a relationship with the Lord that you can draw His attention to the way you've lived. He said that, now look, I have lived this way, and so, you know, I don't want to die right now, because his country was in a mess, and he was the leader at that time. And so the Lord gave him 15 more years. So it was his time to go, but then the Lord changed his mind. And why did he change his mind? Because Hezekiah was praying and really crying out to the Lord. And so, you know, that's when we see differences in our lives, is when we really pray to the Lord from the bottom of our heart. Sometimes we say prayers from the top of our head, it seems like, but when you really pray from your heart, like Hezekiah was doing, because he knew he's going to die, and if we get desperate about things, then we know that God's going to hear, he's going to answer. And so he honored Hezekiah's faith. So I want you to think about this story. This is in Isaiah, the 38th chapter. So if you've got something in your life right now that you need to have the Lord to deliver you from, do like Hezekiah and negotiate with the Lord. Talk to him and ask him, you know, about changing it. And the Lord said he would honor it because he had lived like he said he did. So that is the good thing about the Lord. Regardless of what we need, he knows how to meet our needs. So let's pray and get into the music. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you tonight because we know that you're still the same. You're the same God that answered Hezekiah's prayers. You're the same God that answers our prayers, and you never change. And so we thank you that you can be touched with the feelings of our infirmities or things that are hurting us or troubling us. And when we pour our hearts out to you, we know that you can change things. And so, Father, we know there's so many sick people, so many dying people, so many people that are hooked on drugs and alcohol, family members. And in the letters today, there was several that family members that was really in need to be delivered. And so you know where these folk are, and so we ask for your intervention tonight, Lord. Bless our service, and we're here for one reason, Lord, and that is to try to tell people about you and to point them to the one that can save them, heal them, deliver them, and take them to heaven at the end of life. So help us do a good job of it tonight, Lord. Bless her music and our phone operators and the ones that'll call. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. If you have your little newsletter, you will see we've got Don Lovins and friends, and some are out because of sickness tonight, and then we have a new one. We are happy to have Neth Jones with us tonight, and so they are they're all going to sing and share music with you. And if you like it, why, you can let them know. It won't bother hurt their feelings a bit, would it, Lonnie? Okay, let's go over to the music.
We want to welcome everybody to service tonight. A little short tonight, but we got a good one to make it up. Hope we can sing something spiritually feed you tonight. That's what we're here for. We're going to let our special guest, Neth Jones, take us off.
Well, the battle's not mine, said little David. Lord, it's thine, I'm in your favor. I'm giving it all to you. Lord, I know not what to do, but I'm so glad you let me see that you're really all that I need. 'Cause the battle's not mine, I give it to you, Lord, it's David, oh so small, Goliath, oh so tall, the odds was just too high for little David. So he shook off all of his load, with the power of God he was clothed, said the battle's not mine, I give it to you, Lord, it's thine. No, the battle's not mine, said little David. Lord, it's thine. I'm in your favor. I'm giving it all to you. Lord, I know not what to do, but I'm so glad you let me see. You're really all that I need. 'Cause the battle's not mine, I give it to you, Lord, it's thine. Now, little David, unafraid, before the giant he stood that day. Oh, it seemed to be the end of little David. But like the lion and the bear he slew, he said, Goliath, you're coming down too. 'Cause the battle's not mine, I give it to you, Lord, it's thine. No, the battle's not mine, said little David. Lord, it's thine, I'm in your favor, I'm giving it all to you. I know not what to do, but I'm so glad you let me see that you're really all that I need. 'Cause the battle's not mine, I give it to you, Lord, it's David, he stood so tall, Goliath was so small. Sweet victory had rang on little David, 'cause he gave the battle to the one that has the record for getting things done. Said the battle's not mine, I'll give it to you, Lord, it's thine. No, the battle's not mine, said little David. Lord, it's thine. I'm in your favor. I'm giving it all to you. Lord, I know not what to do, but I'm so glad you let me see
Bubba. I like that song. We might let you do it again some of these days. You gonna do well. This next guy is Robin Lovin, my son. If you need anything out there, call in. That's what we're here for. Help you, lift you up, try to make you feel better.
Sing this song out to Juanita Smith. Terry and Pam Jarvis. And we missed Don and Margaret. We got a good helper over here to help us out. We're going to enjoy him tonight. I'm going to send it out to my wife. I call it my heaven, and I don't care. Call me crazy, 'cause I'm homesick for it. Yet I've never been there. Call me a stranger, 'cause it's all I am, and I know I don't belong. But when he calls me, call me gone. Call me gone. I'll be leaving. Call me gone. You'll be grieving if you left here without Jesus. Call me gone, and all that it takes is for me to hear him call me, then call me gone. Call me foolish because I believe in life after death. Call me delirious because I know someone, though I never have met. Call me a simple man because it's all I am. But I know he sits on the throne. But call me anything. But when he calls me, call me gone. Call me gone. Well, I'll be leaving. Call me gone. You'll be grieving if you're left here without Jesus to call home. Call me gone, no more heartache. Call me gone, and all that it takes is for me to hear. For me to hear him call me, then call me gone.
We're going to send that out to Bill Carr over in London, Kentucky. He likes Robin sing. Don't forget now. I'm a little hoarse, but I'll do the best I can. If you got a song request, call in. Prayer, call in. Somebody pray with you, call. There's a light in the window, and the table set in splendor. Someone standing by the open door. I can see the crystal river. Lord, I must be here forever, 'cause I've never been this homesick before. Well, see the bright light shine. It's just about home time. Well, I can see my father standing at the door. Well, this world has been a wilderness. I'm ready for deliverance. Lord, I've never been this homesick before. God, I'm loving. Can see the family gathering, sweet faces they all familiar, and no one's older people anymore. Think about it. Oh, my lonesome heart is crying. Think I'll spread my wings. 'Cause I've never been sick before. See the bright light shine. It's just about home time. Well, I can see my father standing at the door. Well, this world is in a wilderness. I'm ready for deliverance. Lord, I've never been this homesick before. Well, Lord, I've never been this homesick before. This whole world is a wilderness we're traveling to. There's all kinds of everything in the world going on. Trials, wicked people, I'm telling you, I ain't never seen nothing like it. We're going to do an instrument. Thank you. We was talking about the wilderness a minute ago. But you can get through the wilderness. There's a man called Jesus Christ, but you got to call on. He'll help you get through him. Singles and none good, Nathan. I like his singing. I like his voice.
Well, I was alone and idle, and I was a sinner too. Then I heard a voice from heaven saying there is work to do. Then I took my master's hand and I joined the heavenly band. Now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. And now I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Well, I lost my flag in battle. My staff is in my hand. I'm taking it to Jesus over in the glory land. On the distant land I'll trot. Crying sinner, come to God, and I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him. Savior, this battle it's almost won. The trumpet will be sounding the coming of the sun. I will lay my armor down,
yeah,
pick up my robe and crown, and I'll walk the golden street with my Lord. And now I'm on the battlefield. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. And now I'm on the battlefield for my Savior. This battle is almost won. All the trumpet will be sounding the coming of the sun. I will lay my armor down, pick up my robe and crown, and I'll walk the golden street with my Lord. Yes, I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. I promised him that I would serve him till I die. And now I'm on the battlefield.
get the big boy back up. Little man. He's about tall as me and Don both stacked on top of each other. Fine fella, though. He's good when he's asleep.
That's singing song out to Lonzo Smith, a good old friend of mine. Drops by and sees me a couple times a week. Brings me breakfast and dinner and all kinds of good stuff. We'll send it out to him.
Don't forget, need prayer and song requests, call us in. I got a whole bunch of requests to do this. I figured I was wearing everybody out, but they must like it. Do it for Catherine Cox and her family, in memory of John.
And Geraldine and Donnie.
Geraldine and Donnie from Wally World, Walmart. Everybody's been there. When the last breath of life is green from my body and my lips are as cool as the sea. When my friends gather round at my farewell party, please don't worry about me. There'll be flowers from those who will cry when I'm gone and leave this old world all left behind. I know you'll be sad at my farewell party. Don't worry about me. You better think where you're going to spend your farewell party. When you leave this earth, you're going somewhere. Hope it's the right place. Switch Don around. He's going to think he's going to try the old washboard. Have a little humor here. We thank everybody for tuning in tonight. Hope you're enjoying.
All right, we're going to give them a little break, Don Lovins and friends tonight, and we're missing some, like we said, because of sickness, some of them out. But here we got a whole list of songs for everyone to sing. But here's a real good praise report. This lady is really praising the Lord for what He's done for her. From Boyle County, Sue has called. And she said that she was scheduled to have had surgery on her pancreas and liver, but she called WLJC, and after prayer, then the recent lab work that they've done was very good. She's no more surgery is scheduled for surgery. So that is a wonderful report. That is a healing. Yes, that's to thank the Lord for. All right, May from Knox County wanted Don to play the song 4 Days Late. And then Pam, Don's daughter, wanted to hear him play Amazing Grace. I don't know what on. From Mercer County, Fern wanted to hear the drummer to sing Farther Along. And Juanita, Lonnie and Don's sister, she needs prayer, and she also is listening tonight and enjoying the music. From Lexington, Catherine has, she wants a song on the piano.
I've got it.
And so Don's going to do that, Catherine, for you from Lexington. Joseph Beck is called, and he's still a happy Christian, and he's really enjoying the music tonight. And we met recently a couple at a restaurant, and I think Don talked to him more than I did. I was hungry. I was eating. It was good. I was hungry. William and Charlene Allen from over London, Corbin area. We met them at the restaurant, like I say, and they was telling how many miracles that the Lord had done for him and still brought him through, and he was doing fine. And so we appreciated what they had to say about the station. Mrs. Kavanaugh from Madison County, she's enjoying the program tonight, and she needs prayer for herself and all of those folk that was in that gas explosion today, that losing their homes and that one lady her life. So there's so many things happening around our nation on any given day. You hear about what all's happening, and it helps you to know. We better know the Lord. We better get really acquainted with Him, and because we're going to need Him at more than just on a daily basis. We need Him, of course, but when these calamities happen, for someone that doesn't know the Lord, I don't know how they're going to keep their sanity, because they have nowhere to turn to, and no emotional support, no prayer support. So that's why Ms. Kavanaugh and others are praying for people when they hear them on the news like that. And so we have a number of requests. Brenda has called from Lee County for Shannon Mays having knee problems, it says. Charles from Whitley County, cancer surgery on his face, and he's already had that, and they're having the stitches out tomorrow and wanting to pray that it's healed up. Ola from Jackson County for her family. Kathy from Leslie County for Wanda. Both of these ladies are on dialysis. A lady has called for David from Falmouth, has stomach problems. The doctors can't find out what's wrong. Marvin and Kathy from Clay City, both are needing prayer. Evelyn from Somerset, Taylor, her little granddaughter. Rachel from Madison County and needs prayer. Sherry and Les from Pike County. Tracy and her family from Madison County. Pauline and David from Laurel County found a mass in on Pauline, and she's scheduled for surgery next Thursday. And David has taken a fall, and he's on life support right now. Christine from Rockcastle, unspoken request. Phyllis from Laurel County for Russell Fields and the family. Earl and Goldie both are still sick and needs to be brought to the Lord. Jerry from Lincoln County for the whole family. Mary from Floyd County having nerve damage, it says. And Christina from Corbin. Nona from Knott County. There's a family situation there. Thelma from Madison for her family. Roger from Madison for physical needs. And Lena from Pulaski County, pains in her back and having surgery and family issues. And then we've had several others that folk that we always have prayer here in the studio before the services at night. And the main reason we do this is for everybody to kind of slow down and get together and think about what we're here for. We're here, you know, to try to lift up the Lord and to bring encouragement. And so everyone's busy, and then they come in, and so we always drop everything and pray a little while before we go on the air. And so we had several things mentioned at that time that needs some healing, needs to be taken care of. But I do not know anyone or any situation that doesn't need the Lord, doesn't need the Lord's help. And so we need to be faithful and to pray for others, because you know the trials that they're facing, you might have already gone through, and you know that you're going to survive. And so it's important that we pray one for another. And sometimes you just get so sick and so down, you just lost your will to live. And that's serious when that happens. And so, but we appreciate you calling in and letting us know what songs you like. And they'll see, we'll see how many they can get on, and they'll work on it, I suppose. So, are y'all ready?
Yeah, I'm going to play that sound tape. Make sure people play one.
Okay. All right, I think he's going to do the one for the ones that likes the piano. And I know this one lady from Lexington always calls in to hear. Yeah, she's up in her 90s, and she always likes the piano. So I believe we're going to have that right now. And so, but now go ahead and call if you need to, or if you have a good praise report like that lady did a minute ago. That was wonderful, that the Lord touched her, and no surgery schedule. That's great. All right. All right, let's see. I think they're ready over here, so let's go back to the music. Thank you.
I'm glad I got to teach him how to learn piano. We want to lift up the Lovings family. They had a passing this past week. Mary Bell Loving, lift up the family in your prayers.
One of my favorite songs here, because it's so much to thank him for, and I have got so much to thank him for. When I look around and see the good things he's done for me, I know I'm unworthy of.
His blessing
he freely gives.
I owe
all my life to him. I've got so much to thank him for, and I've got so much to thank him for, so much to praise him for. You see, he's been so good to me, and when I think of all he's done and where he brought me from, I've got so much to thank him for. Sometimes, while I'm on my way, I stop, I kneel, and I say, Lord, thank you for all you've done for me.
One day
I'll reach heaven, sure, oh please. Let me kneel once more, 'cause I've got so much to thank him for, and I've got so much to thank him for, so much to praise him for. You see, he's been so good to me. Got so much to thank him for.
Good. That's a beautiful song. And we do have a lot to thank him for. No matter if you're doing good, you still got something to thank him for. It'd be a bad time coming if you just hold on.
Somebody requested Father Alone. I used to know that song, but I'm afraid I'll forget the words. So I'll do one.
Make them up.
We'll do We'll do this one. I hope we walk the last mile together, hand in hand, we can see the promised land. We've been through a lot of bad times, but our love will last forever, and I hope we walk this last mile together. We made this house a home for our little one. We've known happiness and we've known some sorrow too. We've walked in the sunshine and bared the stormy weather, and I hope we walk the last mile together. I hope we walk the last mile together, hand in hand, we can see the promised land. We've been through a lot of bad times, but our love will last forever, and I hope we walk the last mile together.
I used to know Father Long, but I was afraid I'd mess it up, so we may do another old one, maybe, here in a minute.
I like the way Roy and Key Himes does that song. We need to lift them up in prayer, too. We appreciate them. And we want want to thank her brother here for coming to help us, Phil. He's doing a fine job.
I've enjoyed it. You know, when you pray, and you may feel like sometimes that prayers ain't getting answered, that maybe you think that it can't happen. Maybe a doctor's gave you a bad report, and he says that there's just no hope. Well, that's not the way that Jesus Christ talks about it. He says, by my stripes, that's same as, by his stripes, we're healed. That's what the Bible says, by his stripes. We're healed. And when we can stand up on that, when we can start standing up on his word, we can start seeing healing come into our bodies. We can start seeing people healed that we're praying for. The word of God is true. And we can stand up on that.
Yes, sir.
So what can he do? He can do anything we need him to.
That's right.
Now who can speak to the cripple? They'll stand right up and walk. Who can cause the deaf and dumb to hear and start to talk? Who can calm a fevered brow by saying, let it be? With a little bit of clay, touch him in a way that blinded eyes could see. I'm telling you, he can. And I know that right by your side when the world starts crumbling in. 'Cause there ain't no one ever done what he's done. 'Cause he laid down his life, he rose and lived again. I'm telling you, he can. And I know that he'll stand right by your side when the world starts crumbling in. 'Cause
there ain't no one
ever done what he's done.
What he's done.
'Cause he laid down his life, he rose and lives again. What can cause an old man that's about to say goodbye to lift up both his dying hands and wipe the tear from his eye? With his loved ones gathered all around him, he can smile and say, fear not, for the one that brought me through the storm's gonna lead me on from here. I'm telling you, he can. I know that he'll stand right by your side when the world starts crumbling in. 'Cause
there ain't no one
ever done what he's done.
Because
he laid down his life, he rose and lived again. I'm telling you,
he can.
I know that he'll stand right by your side when the world starts crumbling in.
Yes, he will.
'Cause there ain't no one ever done what he's done.
Because
he laid down his life, he rose and lives again.
Good song, good job. And it's a true song. Play us one. You want to play one? He laid down his life for us, and we should appreciate.
Amen.
No other person would have done that. Thank you. I'm going to let him sing a little. My back's about to go out. My old man, he's got to have a little rest.
That's a country where no twilight shadows deepen. Unending days where nights will never be. A city where no storm will ever gather. This is just will it be when we get over yonder and join the throne upon the glassy sea? We'll join. This is just what heaven means to me. And that when at last we see the face of Jesus, before whose image other loves all flee. I'll be there, 'cause this is just what heaven means to me. What will it be when we get over yonder and join
Just think about it. What does heaven mean to you? You don't want to miss it.
Amen.
The drunk on the street, the rich in their palaces, the poor and unlearned, and men of degree, they all have a soul in need of salvation.
y'all have to come by cavalry. And I am so glad God saves old sinners. I'm thrilled and amazed how he sets them free. But the biggest surprise in redeeming old sinners is that he would save an old sinner like me. Was I so wrong? I needed forgiveness. And was I so bad? I had to be redeemed. I wasn't a thief, but I lived in sin's prison. I was as lost as a sinner could be, and I am so glad God saves old sinners. I'm thrilled and amazed how he sets them free. But the biggest surprise in redeeming old sinners is that he would save an old sinner like me. Take it away. Yes, I am so glad God saves old sinners. I'm thrilled and amazed how he sets them free. But the biggest surprise in redeeming old sinners is that he would save an old sinner like me. Is that he would save an old sinner like me.
I'm going to do one more while he's got the five string. And I'll turn it over to these guys. They all time a tuning on these five strings. They won't stay in tune.
I wandered so aimless, right filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more tonight. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Heck, Earl Scruggs.
Praise
just like a blind man wandered along. Worries and fears I claim for my own. Just like the blind man, God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more tonight. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Yeah, I was a fool to wander astray. Straight is the gate and narrow the way. Now I have traded the wrong for the right. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more tonight. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
God saw me, and he knew about my weakness, and he knew that I was sinking deep in sin. He heard the prayer, he saw the tears of all my sorrow. God reached way below the bottom for me that night. Yes, God reached way below the bottom, and he took my hand. He didn't care if I was the world's most foolish man. He took my heart, he took my soul, he took my mind. And God reached way below the bottom for me that night. I took his hand, he lifted me up out of darkness. He took his blood, his precious blood, and he washed me clean. He took my fear, he took my pain, and all my sorrow. And God reached way below. Yes, God reached way below the bottom, and he took my hand. He didn't care if I was a
world's most foolish man. He took my heart, he took my soul, he took my mind.
Yes, he did.
And God reached way below the bottom for me that night. Yes, God reached way below the bottom for me.
We're going to try to get to one of them requests.
You going to play it or sing?
Pound Terry Jarvis. We got Amazing Grace, one of the biggest songs that I've ever wrote.
Thank you. One morning, they led Jesus up the mountain, and they nailed him to a rugged dogwood tree. It is finished, Jesus cried. Ever since, I'm satisfied that he meant that you ain't seen the last of me. 'Cause there's gonna be a wake up, a get up, grave, get out of my way. It's gonna be a goodbye. Nice try, but death couldn't make me stay. Save every farewell and all your sad mail. I'm headed for the land of the free. Brother, you ain't seen the last of me. So if my loved ones ever gather around my bedside, hear the doctor say my life is about to flee. If you're a Christian in the crowd, when I'm crossing, have no doubt. Brother, you ain't seen the last of me. 'Cause there's gonna be a wake up, a get up, grave, get out of my way. It's gonna be a goodbye. Nice try, but the grave can't make me stay. Save every farewell and all your sad mail. I'm headed for the land of the free. Brother, you ain't seen the light of me. No, brother,
we want to appreciate everybody for watching. Appreciate your call-ins, request. Hope God blessed you tonight. Hope we blessed you. Main thing, Jesus. Amen. That's what we're here for. Lift up his name. We got time for one more. Appreciate you watching.
We're going to send it out to Ruth Smith. There ain't nothing that can't be done by me and God. There ain't nobody gonna come between me and God. One day we'll live forever where the angels trod, me and God. Early in the morning, talking it over, me and God. And late at night, talking it over, me and God. You could say we like two peas in a pod, me and God. My father and he's my friend, the beginning and the end, and he
He rules the world with a staff and a rod. We're a team, me and God. I am weak, but he is strong, me and God. But he forgives me when I'm wrong, me and God. He's the one that I lean on when life gets hard, me and God. He's my father and he's my friend, the beginning and the end. And he rules the world with a staff and a rod. We're a team, me and God. Yeah, he rules the world with a staff and a rod. We're a team, me and God. Yes, we're a team, me and God.
All right. Thank you so much for all those songs. And we have a lot of good things to share. And here's James from Rockcastle just called and was talking about what a good blessing he's received from the singing, especially Neff's singing tonight. So that we appreciate Neff for coming and helping tonight. And here's the best news that we could have. Here's a lady from Jackson County that has called and rededicated her life to the Lord tonight. And her name is Laura. And then from McCreary County, Mary has done the same thing. She's prayed and asked the Lord to help her. She's rededicated her life to the Lord. So if you fellas thought it was a little hard tonight, trying to dig up that many songs so quick, it was worth it all. It was worth it all. Well, Don and Lonnie's cousin, Martha Hammonds from Indiana, she called, and of course she always watches. And Don and Lonnie's are saying howdy over here, Martha. So being from Clay County, you know howdy's real friendly. So, all right, here we have... a 65-year wedding announcement, and they forgot to get the last name, so I'm sorry about that. But Frank and Ruth from Winchester, they've been married 65 years, and they wanted a song. And so that's Frank and Ruth from Winchester, and sorry we did not get the last name. From Wolf County, Velma has called for Misty that has cancer. A boy also needs prayer. And said they've really enjoyed Don Lovins and Friends tonight. Becky from Montgomery County liked the piano playing, and she has trouble with her arm. From Lincoln County, Claudia wanted to, the wife called for Claude, wanted Lonnie to sing Old Brush Arbor. And here's a song request for Esther and Neville. And we'll see if we can get all these these prayer requests in now. From Michigan, Stevens is scheduled for surgery, and someone is doing the intercessory prayer and calling, wanting more prayer for him. Howard from Casey County. And here is a grandmother that is calling for a grandchild that has made some bad choices and is in jail, and a lot of things are going on. And of course, she's praying, and we all would be. And you always pray for your kids. When they need it the most is when you sometimes feel the least like giving them love and support, but that's when they need it the most, is when they're not doing well. And you know, that is the number one prayer request all the time here, is family members. Because I believe God gave families a special love for each other, and that's why it's, you want to see your family do well. If somebody's sick in your family, you spend a lot of time praying for them, thinking about them, visiting, doing what you can. And because it's a special love that he gives to families, I believe. Linda from Whitley County, COPD and ear infection. Here is Brenda and her family. All of them need prayer. Phil from Berea, Phyllis needs prayer. Charlotte from Rockcastle, for Natasha, that's in the Mount Vernon Hospital in the last stages of COPD. From Virginia, enjoying the program, and they're calling for two people. One of them is having a liver transplant, and the other one can't stand up to walk. Fern from Perry County, cancer surgery scheduled on Tuesday. And remember her family, a daughter from Williamsburg, trouble with her feet, and the dad needs prayer also. Michael from Mount Vernon is in UK Hospital. Another one from Laurel County is, she is her husband's caretaker. Archie from Whitley County, COPD, and needs healing. Donnie has called for Charlie that has cancer and needs prayer. Lady from Round County has complications from a stroke. Emma from Estill County, stomach cancer. Betty from Harlan, ear infection and COPD. Addie from London, surgery scheduled. Junior from Knott County for his family. Walter from Laurel County. And Alfia from Morgan County. So there's a number of folk that have called tonight, and we're glad that you have, and we're glad that we can have a chance to pray with you. All we can do is just try to point you to the Lord. We never want anyone to try to follow us or be like us unless we're acting like Jesus. You don't be like anybody. You follow him, not people, because people can let you down, and sometimes they don't even mean to. They have good intentions, but good intentions doesn't really get it, does it? You got to do it. You got to live right. So let's pray for all these. We appreciate all these folk that has their mind on the Lord, and gas explosion today over in Lincoln County, I believe it was. And each day you hear something different, another tragedy, another mishap some way, someone in an accident. We all need the Lord. Let's pray with us. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for all these folk that have their heart and mind on you tonight. And we know that's where you want us to, because you tell us to think about you when we're working, when we are lying down or walking around. We're to love you with all of our heart, soul, and mind. And if we do that, we don't have much time for meanness. And so, Lord, I just pray that you'll bless each one of these people that have called. I thank you that they've got a measure of faith, because you give everyone a measure of faith. So increase their faith, help them to believe for what they need. And have we thank you for the praise reports of how you healed the lady that was scheduled for surgery, because this is not hard for you to do. And we just thank you that it has happened. We pray that you'll continue to bless that person, help her to be able to live a long life serving you. And for the young people that's in jails and prisons and so forth, and the parents and grandparents are carrying the burden and praying, well, I ask for a special comfort to come to them tonight. Lord, that burden gets so heavy and so such a fearful thing, not knowing what's going to happen to their loved one. I just pray for a special touch for these families that have that burden tonight. Bless everyone that has spent this time with us, and Lord, help us all to be more like you tomorrow when we get up. In Jesus' name, amen. We appreciate all of you that have called, and appreciate Neth Jones for coming and helping. And, you know, we have a lot of things we're planning for the ministry, and we know that school is starting for a lot of the children and adults right away, and that's always that really puts people in a different pace of working, because they have to, you know, do the responsibility of getting the children to school too. But I'm glad that the Lord can help there too. We need to pray for safety for our children as they go to school, the transportation and the safety when they get there. And we need to pray for our nation to have a turnaround. And 2 Chronicles 7:14 has told us plainly, if we turn back to God and repent of our wicked ways, then He will hear. We will hear from heaven, and He will heal our lands. And He knows exactly how our land needs to be healed tonight. And you might think, well, it's so bad everywhere that it's impossible. No, it's not. Take one person at a time, and you let yourself be changed by the Lord, and then that is a good start on the rest of the world. And that's exactly what we can do, and we will be held accountable if we don't. So I just trust that you've enjoyed the music and going to be able to have a good night of rest. We know sometimes people dread to see a night time come, because, you know, it seems like at night the pains are worse, and they're just I don't know, but it's harder at night. And so need an extra little pat on your head from your angel tonight, so you can get a good night of sleep. And we do want to remind you that starting a new month here, we have some new singers coming, and we're going to be making a little bit of a change in our daily, weekly schedule here. And so you just stay tuned, and you'll see the change, and we're hoping that you'll like it. So because we're going to provide more gospel music to come your way, and we know that you like that. So so we thank the Lord for these two souls that was saved tonight, and for His goodness. Isn't it wonderful to know that the Lord loves you, and that you don't have to be afraid of anything? If the world came to an end tonight, if you have the right relationship with the Lord, having accept forgiveness for your sins, that's what makes the right relationship. Well, then you'll be okay. You'll be okay. Well, all right. Thanks so much for spending this time with us. Appreciate those that are writing to us and letting us know how your families are doing, and praying for the ministry. We really need that on a daily basis. We need prayer for this ministry, because it's reaching out, and we want it to be the best possible. All right, our time is come and gone for another night. So from all of us, we want to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call us or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy and it's free. May God bless you.